Being a producer is about putting your life into your music. You're sort of giving life to music, as in you are music yourself.
Being a producer is about sending message to people, you see. So it is important to me when I'm trying to send some messages out there.
Being a producer and being an artist at the same time is more empowering than being an artist, because it boosts a lot of self-confidence, especially if you're producing good music, then people start to admire you. Music is actually a nice way to empower yourself. I've got this certain talent that I have now, and there's a lot of people with the same talent, but they don't have the same knowledge that I have. So what I'm trying to do here is create a platform for other people, you know. That's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to create, like, if I can say something to describe it better, is like, if you have a fish, it's better to teach a person to get fish than sharing the one piece of fish that you have with him, because it's not going to be filled. At least if you teach him how to get fish, then you know that when you're gone, he'll be able to survive for himself, you understand? That's my philosophy around the music.
Right? That's how we do this thing, right? From a Joza son. Suffo is who I is. Yeah. Listen up, right?
We have a lot to say in music than just talking to a person. Because it's getting, actually listen to it when you're not there. Where we stay, there are a lot of things that are happening, you see. Now, every time, every generation that comes, it changes what is happening, you see. So what I'm trying to do is just to send a message, you see, to these young ones that are growing up. We were also like, how can I say, naughty when we grow up, you see. But these guys that are following us, they're doing it at a younger age than us, you see. Like robbing people, stuff like that, you see. That does you don't gain nothing about that. Because you're gonna take this, maybe this camera, you bought it maybe for 5,000. That guy's gonna sell it for $500 just to get what he wants, you see. So messages like that. Now that people know me, I see that there's nothing to that, like people knowing you. What I wanted is the message to be heard.
I feel like this is it now, my time is finally here. I gotta set my wings free, now I wanna be there. I got dreams to fulfill, but the language of peace and the clean money is released, and I'm there for Lucas Magatisa. Going ahead, so
people here in Grahamstown, they saw us as in we lack quality here in Grahamstown. You see, like there are many artists here in Grahamstown, but the problem is the studios and that quality stuff and all those things, and they have to go outside to do music. So, my main role is to keep them here in Grahamstown and do music here in Grahamstown, because a lot of artists claim to have studied in Grahamstown. So it's important to me that I keep them here. I used to have a job, but I'm still working on that, because I decided to take off at work so that I can be busy doing music. So I have to do what I have to do, and I have to work with something that I love, that I can give my whole life to, you know, that this is work for me.
I'm working there as a petrol attendant at the garage, Settler City Toyota. But the way that I started recording, it was difficult. So I know how these people that are writing with no recording studios to record, it's hard for them. So I do actually, like, it's cheap, but I ask them $5 for maybe a beat or something. So I actually do it for people, not for me, you see.
For me, it's not more about being financially independent, because I do have work. I'm a police official, yeah, and it's basically the police work that's helping me fund the studio, you know. But it's more basically on helping other people that don't have work, and I know them, they have this skill of music, so just helping them out at the end of the day. There's not a lot of jobs around, you know, man, and if you can create something with what you've got, then might as well try it.
Let's start it over.